And welcome back to the wonderful world of Warhammer. We are here, I believe, just where we left off last time. Turn 131. I had just defeated another set of pesky beastmen armies over here, and won a few battles against the vampire counts over in their neck of the woods. What else was happening? Ah, yes, these guys are still raiding me, and this army has finally finished. This army has finally finished recruiting, so I am going to march and try to eliminate this Jagged Horn army here, hopefully within the next few turns. What else? Ah, yes, I believe, hopefully, that my lord... Yes, he is back. I don't know if I actually want to recruit him over here. I think what I would really like to do... Can I recruit him here? Yes. Alright, I am going to recruit... There. Recruit. Yes. Alright, so Orion is back.
Can I offer assistance?
And this stack here really is originally his army. I would like to do is can I recruit any troops? Alright, that is possible.
Lady of the Glade,
so let's kind of swap here. What? Alright, never mind, that was stupid.
Lady of Athelmoran.
Again. You. Go back. There we go, to your main lord.
How can I assist you?
And this unit is still garrisoned here, so let's get some units for her. Let me see. Again, I really like these units. These units are nice. Yeah, and these are really good. Again, I get Vanguard. There we go. I get Vanguard deployment. Plus, they do this magic damage. Alright, and two at a time. But again, the missile range is a little bit lower compared to the other units, but still very good. And... what else would be good there? I think... Are they still... They are still giving me this nonsense about not being able to recruit this. I have this building. I have an Asrei army. Alright, whatever. Let us build... one unit... and one unit. This will have to be recruited on the next turn, I think. So, yeah, if we do that, we can just keep on stacking them. So let's go like that. And again, he just spawned in, so he is not able to move around at all. Who is this? Right, those are the rebels. Alright, I'm not terribly worried about the rebels. Yeah, they are basically dead. They are going to be taken out really soon. I would like to take this back eventually, but for now that will have to wait. Let me see. Paravan. No, I mean this unit here. Who is he? Bordelais. Bordelot. Alright. Sorry, let's repair it. Repair. Alright. Next. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so it looks like they're sieging. Yeah, they're sieging there. You know, I'm gonna... I'm going to do this one by hand again. There's a little bit of overlap here. And I do have these Vanguard units. Are they Vanguard? No. I have these five Vanguard units here. And I should be able to get rid of these two units pretty quickly. And if I can do that, the rest of their units will start to crumble. And again, these five here are pretty weak. And if I can take them out, again, maybe I'll be able to eliminate them. Excuse me. Okay, and here we go. Yes. Anytime soon. Alright. Let's get the Vanguard units up. There we go. Up here. Quick pause. Yeah, let's take out... Let's have those target them, and let's just march these units. Nope, not that spread out. Up to here for now, because again, the reinforcements are coming from the left flank. Oh, alright. Alright, that is... No, hurry. Yeah, I do not want to let them reach their other units. There we go. The Hawk Riders to attack as well. There we go. Good. Alright, their enemy lord has been eliminated. Let's get these units to focus on the hero unit. Alright, it looks like the hero unit has been eliminated. The reinforcements are still marching their way through these woods. Kind of see a few of their units over here. Alright, let's... Alright. Good. They've been eliminated, so let's reform. Let's reform for battle here. Alright, so this is just a little bit difficult to see with this nighttime map. I'm gonna send these forward to scout and to harry them a little bit. Let's put one on this side, let's put one on the other, and let's rearrange them forward a bit. And same thing, I think I'm actually going to send my Great Eagle out to scout some. Let's see what we can see here. Get a little bit of movie cam going. Whoa. Enemy magic. Magic is weak. All right, that wasn't as dramatic as I thought it would be. Hold on, let's... Let me turn this one off, go back to free camp. Where exactly are... They are just really slow in moving forward, aren't they? Alright, so there's... Again, this nighttime combined with the forest just makes it really difficult to see who I am up against. These trees, come on. Alright, so here... There we go. There is Heinrich Kimmler himself. There's Nicola Diehl. I am going to have my Hawk Riders focus on Kimmler. And same thing for my Great Eagle. I'm going to have them focus on him. Oh, that is no good. They lost sight of him. There we go. There's the Great Eagle. Pounce. Where did he go? He got knocked way back. There he is. I really dislike how the Great Eagle just tends to get caught up in outside battles, you know, fighting against these guys instead of attacking the main lord like I requested. Come on, take him out. Take him out. Alright, good. Their lord is down. There's my Great Eagle. Where are... I think I'll have my Great Eagle focus on her, but I know that there was another... Yes, these guys. Let's have my Hawk Riders focus on them. Alright, good. There's another one down. Man, they have just got a ton. There we go. Of these Lord units. Yeah, alright, so he's still going in. Have they even... Yeah, they are still nowhere near getting close to my army, but I'm gonna keep them in that position for now. Hopefully these units can do enough damage to eliminate some of their lords. Because I remember from playing as the vampire counts that their units just, you know, they do not break. By definition, they do not break. You know, how can you scare something that's already dead? But if you can eliminate their leadership, they do crumple into nothingness pretty quick. So, alright, good. Wait, did I actually eliminate? Yes, alright, one has been eliminated. So let's continue focusing. Alright, good. My eagle is doing okay. Its health is a little bit low. Yeah, they are getting kind of close over here to my units. Just kind of in the middle of that forest still, but almost approaching it. Almost approaching the edge. Alright. Elsa von Drack is almost down. And pounce. That never really gets old. There you go. Good. Alright, she is down. Let's focus on Rambert. Is it the Scarred or the Scared? The Scarred. Okay, so finally some of their units, again, are getting a little bit closer to mine. winning or losing. Yeah. Sorry, I do not want to lose my great eagle quite yet. I'm gonna tell them to run away. Go and let's get these two. Yeah, let's focus on them just to eliminate one of their units early. They're alright for now. Alright.
Archers ready! Fire!
Ah, there we go. Skirmish mode is on. There. Why is this guy still on the ground? Get out of there. I said 100. Ah. There you go. Finally. Alright, he is flying away. How about these ones? They are just hanging out back here. Yeah, that is no good. I want to get them. Let's at least... Rambart the Scare. Why are they not attacking him? I thought I told them to attack him. Alright, in any case, let's eliminate their last hero unit if we can. These two archer units, let's have actually focus there. Skeletons are almost down there. Let's check how is the battle going over here. It says they are even, but it says they are winning. Well, one of them is lying. Okay. Alright, good. These guys are crumbling. Good. Weak binding. Weak binding. I keep riding around in circles. Alright, it's probably not gonna be very much help, but I will send my eagle back to attack these blood knights. And pounce. How are we doing? Winning decisively. Okay, that's good, but again, the health is diminishing pretty quickly there. Double check. There's a corpse cart. Why? Alright, hold on. The question is, did they eliminate the guy? If they did, then maybe they have a right to be attacking. But I do not believe that they could have eliminated him already. But actually, I don't see him anywhere, so maybe... Alright, maybe they did eliminate him. Alright, maybe they are okay attacking there. Alright, so one of my hawk units has used up all its ammo. Sent them in. That's one of the things that I really wish this game, I guess series, really, did a much better job. Now they're winning again. Did a much better job on. Is just teaching you what all the symbols mean. Like the green is pretty clear that it has to do with the health and the number of units, but this bar down here, they never explain that this bar means ammo. That's just, it's like something out of Monty Python, right? Alright, these two units are now clear. Let's... Oh, is that it? Who's left? These Blood Riders are the only ones left, I think. Alright, that basically, that's going to be victory, because they're crumbling. Yeah, there you go. Fall to pieces. Sweet. Alright, I'm glad that I fought that one by hand. Again, just the AI does not seem to auto-resolve battles very well. They seem to think the players are complete idiots. Yeah, that was predictable. There you go, there's the Warriors of Chaos moving in on my territory a bit, getting close to it at least. Okay. Excuse me. So I believe I am going to attempt one of the battles for my hero unit's main questline. Alright, whoa, who? Okay, they sent another one. And it's just... Yeah, I'm gonna auto-resolve this one. There's not a whole lot of point. Come on. Alright. Okay, so wow, the Bjornling are totally gone now. Yes, I know about that one. Where is Waldenhof? Why do they want me to build one there? The only reason that I can really think of for building one there is, you know, just that it is the last of the outposts, or settlements rather, for the vampire counts. Alright, in any case, my main lord...
Lady of the Azrae!
Ready to serve!
Yeah, my main lord is pretty much has a full stack here. I'm gonna save real quick, and I believe I'm going to go ahead and attempt... I believe it is this one. Yeah, I am going to attempt. Alright, that's... Well, hold on. This is different than I remember. Eternal Guard with shields. Okay, they have a lot of regular infantry units, but actually not that many of these units. Alright, but I'm gonna go ahead and reinforcements are expected. Let's go ahead and give this battle a try. Wow, so this lord has got... Sweet. Alright, he's got a forest dragon for his mount. Let me see, this is leadership. Let's give it to one of them. And yeah, let's fight this. Now they do have more cavalry than I do. In fact, yeah, I do not have any shock cavalry or any melee cavalry at all. So I'm gonna have to be careful of these two units here, I think.
The seasons move ever on, and I feel the call to the Oak of Ages. Before I return to Ariel's embrace, another must be chosen to be born anew.
Gorgeous map. It looks like this is at the foot of the Oak of Ages, I think.
Through their blackened hearts. These curs cannot be suffered to live. Though we challenge Anna Framer herself, the will of Kurnos must spurn her once more and overcome these perverse desires.
All right, let me just check out. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that is the Oak of Ages itself. That is pretty badass. That thing is huge. Yeah, got these gigantic trees. All right, so back to the matter at hand. Let's get our usual setup here. So they're gonna be spawning in somewhere inside that tiny box. I am gonna go ahead and move my vanguard units. Yeah, I do not really want them set up like that. Vanguard units like that. And let's get my main set up. There. And have them set up there. And let's keep these two flying units off to the right flank. Have my treekin go here. And have the Lord and the Spellsinger over this flank. Alright, the champion of Anathrema, the murderer of its own kin, now stands before the Great Oak. Slay him at once and bring justice to the fallen. Okay, so here is their main lord on his forest dragon. Alright, so the goal of these right now, I think, is going to be to eliminate these Wild Riders. They are the closest, and they are the only unit that I cannot really counter with speed or anything like that. So I'm gonna try to eliminate them so that they cannot flank me. Probably next move on to these units here. Alright, there we go. Fire, fire, fire. Alright, make sure skirmish mode is on. There you go. Alright, so he has already moved into range. Let's cast a hex there. And then same thing. I'll wait on that one for a little bit, actually. Go and question. Yeah, this is just area, so I will be able to attack these melee units, but is there anything I can do to the Lord self? Alright, looks like no. So missile resistance. There for now. Alright, these units, let's have attack there, because they are out by themselves, and my tree kin, before they get any fancy ideas about swinging around my right flank, let's kind of march my tree kin forward there. Alright, continue. Why is he going this way? He should not be going that way. Stay over here. Crap. Hold on, I want to double check this. I could have sworn... I know that there was one spell that had the possibility of doing damage to your own troops, but I cannot remember if it was this one. I could have sworn that it was this spell that did damage to your own troops. So I'm pretty sure I do not want to use that spell. Forward a little bit. Sorry, go back to these units here. How are they doing? Yeah, let's focus there. Yeah, he's getting his butt handed to him. Cast that there. Okay, there's reinforcements coming in. So my vanguard units are going to start moving back. Give a little bit more support here. Whoa, alright, yeah. See, they're coming in trying to charge me. But let's teach them that that's a bad idea. Oh, shit, 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 shit. Yeah, there's more wild fuck. Alright. Yeah, let's pull those units back. I don't think I actually need those spear units to stay right here, because I do have this cliff. I don't even think I really noticed it before, but there is this cliff right in front. Air combat even. They are just sitting again. I don't quite understand why they're sitting on their butts there, but whatever. How about over here? Yes, all right, unpause. Let's get some support for them. Yeah, they are firing. Yeah, they're gonna get taken down. Yeah, that is just a disaster. My poor... I really feel kind of bad for them, but these Vanguard units really are getting the short end of the stick. Let's give them a little bit more support here. And you guys... Yeah, back here. And these... Yeah, again, I definitely want to attack there. There, alright, my forest dragon is doing fine. Alright, it would probably be a good idea. Yeah, let's cast that. And let's... hex this area. Them out. Do my puppies there. These again, this unit, I would really prefer both of these units, really. I would really prefer not to lose. Alright, that's one of their units. Yeah, I was afraid of that. Alright, the treekin. Alright, let's send one unit back here. They, I think, are just gonna have to make do. My dragon. Yeah, I'm gonna keep my dragon there for now, I think. Let me see about the Hawk Riders. Quickly! Yeah, I would prefer to get the Hawk Riders out of range, those archers. Okay, so there, okay, their main lord is routing. So that is good. I do have two units there, but I really want to get these guys out of there. I'm just gonna send my main lord in. There. And let's do an explosion there. And yes, have them attack there. And you know, while they're at it, they're kind of out of danger right now, so let's attack over there. You guys have focus there. All right. Yeah, they're doing fine there. It looks like most of their units are retreating now. Again, these three, I keep telling them to run away. And somehow they never seem to move. Yeah, get out of there. That And cast a spell there. Bam! Ah. Alright, so that is the end of the battle. I think I might end up losing these two units. But overall, not too bad, I would say. Alright, so quest is complete. Ton of loot. Yeah. Gotta level up. What can I do? Release them. Kill them. You know, I'm gonna do this one for sure, actually, because it would be... Yeah, it would definitely be most beneficial, since these are of the same faction as myself, to recruit them into my army and get increased unit replenishment. Alright, so there's that. And I have the Spear of Kurnos. Kurnos. Missile damage plus 10%. Recruitment cost is minus 10%. Income from post-battle loot is plus 10%. And alright. Sweet. Alright, let's level these two up. I'm definitely gonna go with this regrowth one, because, yeah, increasing their hit points is always a useful thing to have. Yeah, Spear of Kurnos. Kurnos. Sorry, keep saying it wrong. Alright, I didn't notice that he had this over here. Let's see. And he is level 23, so it's going to be a long time before I get the chance to level him up again. Speed has already been maxed out. I've already maxed out melee defense and melee attack. Armor has been maxed out. Okay, I haven't maxed out this, and I haven't maxed out the weapon strength. Let's go with missile... Yeah, let's go with missile damage for now. So that will be maxed out. Yeah, that I want to keep that. That special ability does come in pretty handy. Let's get him... I didn't notice that I had an extra pendant here that was not being used, but let's get that one on. Alright. They're all set. Let's go back over here. Man, they are just out of range. Traveling. Yeah, let's march them up. Okay, yeah, the main battle there still is available. There is another army over here, but there we go. There's Durthu. Let's... There, let's move him over there. Keep these two units together, I think. Yeah, these two should be sufficient. I am hoping. The only thing is Findl has these War Dancer units with the swords instead of the spears, and every time I go into battle, they take massive losses. Alright, I'm gonna... Let's save again. Yes. Alright. And right, they are letting me get right up next to them because they keep resetting. They keep resetting. So let's, yes, I'm going to declare war. Good. Alright. Again, I'm gonna auto-resolve this one, but I'm fully anticipating that maybe one of those units is gonna be dead. Alright. That is good. Okay, they got a level up. That is also good. Alright. Execute the captives.
Beginning my journey.
And let's march on them again.
I go then.
This time again, I'm gonna initiate it with Catra. And this time, whoa, no. Why? That's very odd. Alright, in any case, it's only this army. Do a quick save just in case. Damn it. Alright, yeah, I'm gonna reload that one. Fight it by hand. Yeah. Right. Yes, whatever. Quick save. Yeah, the auto-resolve just is... It's a very, very handy mechanic, because really, nobody wants to spend the hundreds upon hundreds of hours that it would take to manually fight all of those battles. But still, I should not have totally lost that many units. Yeah, whatever. Let's kill this Sla Feastbringer. Yeah, alright. Yeah, start deployment. I am gonna move these units all up here. And again, I know that's probably not too smart, but there you have it. Yeah, let's keep those units here behind these trees. Make it a little bit difficult for them to spot me. And all of my units are basically hidden. This is kind of interesting. If I move them over here, it says they're still hidden. Yeah, it says all of them. Okay, these units are not hidden. They're marching in the open. They can see these units. But these guys are still invisible. So they have no idea. That these guys are here. That presents some very interesting opportunities. Yeah, these guys will have to move forward a little bit more. But they should. Let's see if we can take out their Sigor, actually. Just move them forward a little bit. Cast a hex on them. Get an explosion going there. Yeah. And alright, these guys are not hidden anymore. The Sigor. Okay, so there is a gore herd kind of hidden Whoa. Alright, again, that was a wee bit stupid. Okay, more than a wee bit stupid. Yeah. It on them. He is still back there.
War dancers!
It's really just almost impossible to see clearly what's going on in these forest battles. I understand that's basically the point, but man, it would be nice to see what's going on a little bit more clearly. Actually, is their lord dead already? Was that what that message was about? Yeah, alright, good. Their lord has already been eliminated. Let's send mine forward. And let's... let's replenish their HP. See, and even I screwed up my deployment pretty badly, and still, these guys are not even close to being totally eliminated. So I don't know how the computer is deploying its units in order to arrive at that conclusion. So that looks like it's basically victory. Again, I'm gonna keep playing a little bit longer. Come on. It'd be really nice to take out that Minotaur. Okay, the Cyagor is eliminated. But I don't want to let these guys get away. Wow, and this is his super fast movement. Moving fast. That's what it says. Moving fast. God. They've been back there the whole fucking time. Alright, whatever. There we go, that slowed them down a bit. Attack. There you go. And two left. Come on, take them out. And speed things up a bit. Yeah, I think he's gonna reach the edge of the map before I get to him. Alright, let's end the battle. Yeah, see, no units are completely wiped out. I will admit, this one is close, but still. Kill the captives. They've got... this guy's got a level up. Let's see... yeah, let's increase the power of this spell here. And... let's send this army this time. Because they're basically on their last legs. There, alright. This, again, is probably going to be really stupid, but I'm going to auto-resolve it. Alright, safe. Good, they got a level up. No units were eliminated. It looks like they are all dead. And I got a rank gain. Okay. Kill their captives. The beastmen are gone. Alright. Now... I'm getting close to the limit of what I can record in one go, so I'm gonna stop the video there, and thank you all for watching.